Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and this is Life with Leaboo. So for today's video, it is going to be a story time. I posted on my Instagram, I did a poll. I posted on there and Snapchat on if I should do a nail unboxing or a story time, and you guys all voted for a story time, which I'm really excited about. So the story time I'm going to talk about today is my college journey and how I ended up where I am right now at this moment, a senior at Ottawa University in Kansas. So yeah, you know, I'm not gonna ramble on too much. We're just gonna jump right into the video. So this all started for me back in 2016 when I graduated high school. So you know how you're supposed to, it's decision day, your last year in high school. You know, you're supposed to know where you're going to college at for the fall and all this stuff. And me, you know, I didn't know where I was going to college yet because I waited last minute, of course. And sorry, I got a notification. I waited last minute, of course. And yeah, I just wasn't on top of it like I should have been, especially because I did want to go to college, but I would say I didn't take it seriously. So, you know, fast forward to it's time to, you know, really for me, it's time to apply to a college because I didn't apply and decision day came and I didn't know where I was going. So I ended up applying to Montclair State University. Now, I applied to them, I think in March. And the reason why I only applied to that school only was because Montclair was like my only, like really my only choice. Like I didn't want to go really nowhere else. And not even, yeah, I really didn't want to go nowhere else. And I didn't really like look into anything else. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I want to go to Montclair because at the time I've danced my entire life. I've danced all the way up until high school. I danced in high school and like at a studio. And you know, it was just in my blood to just like continue it. Like I was just like, I love dancing so much. It's my happy place. Like I'm about to just continue this. But that wasn't the case. I applied to Montclair, like I said, and a couple months later, maybe 2 months, I believe, I seen people that I know, like I knew from high school, getting their letters back that applied to Montclair. And I'm just like, okay, like, where's mine? You know what I'm saying? Because whether or not you get accepted or rejected into a college, you still get a letter telling you, you know, you don't just get a letter of just being accepted. You get one of a rejection too, if you didn't know. So I got a letter in the mail, and mind you, y'all, I'm so excited because I'm like, oh my God, it's from Montclair. Like, I hope I got in, you know what I'm saying? And mind you, Montclair at the time required a letter of, what are they called? You get into college letter, like, you know, about yourself and stuff. Why you feel like you need to be at this college or something. And my grades weren't the best, but that didn't matter because I still wanted to go to Montclair and I didn't think that, you know, anything of it. So I got my letter in the mail and your girl got a rejection letter. She didn't get accepted. And y'all, my heart was so broken. Like I was so sad because it was just like, yo. And I wouldn't even say I was certain that I was gonna get accepted, but I was just like, yo, like this Montclair, like they got dance and everything I need here. That's where I need to go. That's where I need to be. But God had a different plan for me. I guess that wasn't where I needed to be. So yeah, I was sad about that for a while. But, you know, I had to figure out where I was going to go to school because I wanted to go to college. So my cousin, my twin, Tasha, shout out to you. I love you so much. She is a guidance counselor. And she's, you know, she graduated from college and everything. And she, you know, helped me get into, you know, apply to schools. And I applied to one more school, Cheney University in Pennsylvania, the first HBCU. And months go by and I got accepted. And I remember to this day, I wouldn't say I was like ecstatic, But I would say I was happy because it was just like, and grateful because at least at least a school accepted me and I'm going to college. Like, it's real, you know. I am the first generation. No one in my family has ever been to college. So that just said a lot for itself. So, who am I asking? don't mind this bonnet, y'all. Listen, it's the weekend. Not doing my hair. What was I saying? That's what happens when I get off. I'm the first generation in my family. So yeah, got accepted. Fast forwarding to my family, my parents and my godparents decided to throw me a going away party, which was very sweet of them, and they didn't have to do that. I appreciate everybody who still remembers it till this day and who came out to support. Thank y'all so much. It helped me out a lot in my first years of college. Things were great so far, you know. So I was about to get ready to go. Now it's time. We home, packing up my stuff that I want to take down with me. Because if those who don't know, you know, I live in New Jersey. And Pennsylvania is not really far from me. I know from other people who live in Jersey, it's a little far. But, like, depending on what part you're from, like, it's not far from me. I'm probably, like, a good hour and 30 minutes. Maybe less than that. You know, depending on traffic and stuff. So we got there fine. So me and my parents, you know, packed the car. We pull up to the school. And it was just very overwhelming for me. I'm not gonna lie, I was very emotional because I'm always around my parents. I'm always with my parents. So leaving them until Thanksgiving, y'all, I was really a mess. Like, my dad cried. And dad, if you're watching this, yes, you did. You cried. I got the picture till this day. He cried and I started crying. And like, it was just like, yo, cause like, I'm really going to college. Like, this is crazy. And it was just bittersweet. So like, I get there, you know, we had to go to Marcus Foster and we had to like, this is where the students went and like they had something for the parents. So I had to like get my email together. What else I had to get? I had to get like my mailbox key, my dorm room key, all of that. I had to find out like who my roommate was, all of that stuff. So, you know, if you know for your first year, it is very hectic. It is very like a process because you're basically finding out like who you're about to live with for like a year. Did all of that and what happened? Oh, and then that's when I met Sid, my roommate at the time. And we was cool, you know, we hit it off right at the back, dope, you know, like she's from Jersey as well. And things was good. Now mind you, I don't think, listen, y'all, this is from 2016, so you know, I don't know, but I believe I'm right. We weren't each other's roommates. Like, they didn't assign us as roommates, but both of our roommates didn't show up to orientation. And mind you, I think we only had one day of orientation and they didn't show up or whatever. So, excuse me, we're like, we're both from Jersey. We might as well be roommates. We cool, you cool, I'm cool. Like, what's up? So we ended up being roommates. I believe that's how it went. And next thing you know, like, things was good. So now we pulling up to where my dorm is and I'm about to live for a year. And y'all, the ghetto, the trap, a mess. It was just not it. Like, it was called King Hall. But I will say that, like, I met great people. Some people who I still talk to this day, like, yo, King Hall was a mess. It was just a mess. It was that freshman dorm that was just like, it was a mess, but you know, it was great times. It was very, you know, we made our room chill, cozy, made it feel like home. My parents helped, you know, and everything. Her parents helped. Like, it was just a vibe, you know. It was like, it was great energy. So now it was time for my parents to leave and stuff. Like I told y'all, my dad cried, I cried. I don't think my mom cried because I don't think she did. Like, it was just very rude. So like I was saying, it was very emotional for me because I'm just like, you know, I'm like so close to my parents, so being away from them, it was very hard for me for a while. I would say for a good month, and then I got used to it, you know. So yeah, you know, now it's time to settle in. Things was good. Things were going great. So now we're fast forwarding to, you know, a year passes now. I'm still there. And things just wasn't working out for me. I stayed from 2016 to, I believe, yeah, 2016 to fall 2017. Yes, fall 2017. And I was just, you know, not happy. I just wasn't, it wasn't it. It just wasn't it for me. Like, I wasn't, you know, that feeling that I felt before wasn't there anymore. Like, I don't, you know, it just, you know, I just, it was just time for me to really go. So, you know, I ended up withdrawing from the university. I finished out the fall semester. I wasn't just gonna not finish. So I finished out the fall semester. And mind y'all, at this point, my GPA was horrible. I don't know how they didn't even throw me out yet. Because I believe at some schools, you need to remain have a 2.0 or a 2.5 to even stay at the school. Or maybe that's just like mainly for athletes. I don't know how it works, but I believe so it was that. But I'm going to be real with y'all because I know the real, like I know how I am and how my grades can be. And this just wasn't me. That's why I knew it was time for me to go. My GPA, y'all, went to a 1.6. Take a second. A 1.6. 1.6. And you know, that was disgusting. That was just so disgusting. But I can't, you know, I wouldn't take it back. And I just got to learn from it. And I did learn from it. And I did do better. But it was just like, wow. It showed a lot. So I ended up withdrawing from the university. You know, went over, filled the paperwork out. Left there, moved out. So now I'm back home. It's winter break. So now I'm just deciding, okay, where I'm going to go to school. Because it's the middle of the semester. What are we about to do? So, you know, at the time, you know, things was in the works, things was happening, and I ended up transferring to Hudson Valley Community College. It is in upstate New York, in Troy, New York. And yes, I ended up transferring there, visited the school, and it was beautiful, you guys. Like, it was so beautiful. Like, this campus, it really could have been a university. Not even a community college. It could have been a university. But, you know, it was a community college and it was beautiful. I love that school till this day. I love that school. That school has done so much for me. So, yeah, I did transfer there and I got my associate's degree there. So, yes, I do have a degree. And my, like, journey there was beautiful. Like, the teachers, the professors were amazing. Till this day, those professors are the best professors I have ever had, literally. Like, they care about you, they want to see you succeed, and it was just amazing. They never gave me a hard time. Financial aid never gave me a hard time. Like, everything was just on point. They were on point with everything. So everything was just great there, y'all. Like, oh my god, the vibes, the energy. And now that school, I was 3 hours from home, I believe, or four. I think I was three. And I don't know what it was, y'all, but I started to like grow a liking for being far away. After I left chaining and everything, I started to grow a liking for it. Like, I was like, I like the distance. It's far from my parents, but you know, my friends and stuff, but like, I love the distance for some reason. I like that feeling. I don't know what it was, but I don't know. So things was just working out great. They had off-campus housing because it's a community college, so they didn't have on-campus. So they had off-campus, but I didn't want to live in those apartments, so I got my own apartment. And, you know, things was just great. You know, rent was expensive. The first apartment rent was expensive. Then, you know, another year, I did another year there, and then, you know, the rent went down and everything, you know, things like that. Everything worked out great. So it was just like, it was really amazing. Like, it was just beautiful. I wasn't there alone at the time. I was there with my boyfriend at the time. He was going to school there as well. We both got our degrees there. And, you know, we helped each other out a lot. you know, I couldn't have probably done that by myself, especially with everything that was going on. So things really, really were great. They were. Things were great for a while. But then, you know, it was time to, you know, go, because I ended up graduating in May of 2019. And it was just, y'all, it was so beautiful. Graduation. First of all, graduation was hot, okay? Hot. And they got us in these black cap and gowns. And I, if you know me, I don't like to be hot. I cannot be hot. I can't. My attitude will be so disgusting. You will not probably want to talk to me. I cannot be hot. It's not it. No, I do not want to be hot. And it was long. And it went by majors. Because I know some schools, I don't know how some schools are, but that school went by majors. And I was, I'm a business major. So my department was so big. And I'm, my last name was with a J. So, I mean, I'm not at the end, but I'm in the middle, but I'm in the end. No, it was just no. And it was taking a sweet time. But it was good, though. It was great. Everything worked out great. So then I ended up moving out, you know, of my apartment there. My time there came to an end. And I was just so sad because it was so beautiful, y'all. It was so beautiful. Like, that school, you know, was amazing for me. Y'all, I went from a 1.6 GPA. 1.6. To a 3.8 and made president's list. I was so proud of myself. I was up late nights. I was in the library all the time. Y'all, I was busting my butt trying to get that GPA. Trying to prove to myself that I know I could do this. Like, you know, and I did it. And when I made president's list and I saw my name on the thing, I was so proud. Y'all, I was so proud of myself. I was just like, girl, you did it. Y'all, I was so proud. I was so proud because, number one, my GPA has never been that high. And I made president's list. Like, that's crazy. So, yeah, things was just great for me. So, if I could recommend to you guys, now, of course, this is up to you guys. If I would have not been so hard-headed, because I know people told me to start out at a community college, then transfer in, especially because it's cheaper. I would have started out at a community college, probably not Hudson Valley, because, you know, things, that's how, it's ways I ended up there, you know what I'm saying? But I would definitely have went to a community college, then went to a four-year. That's it. Like, I really would have, if I would have known, like, I really would have, because I would have saved so much time and energy, and it was amazing. That school, y'all, I missed that school so much. But yeah, so that was my time there. So always know that when you push yourself and you got people around you who want to see you succeed and, you know, are going to be there for you no matter what, and they got your back no matter what your decisions are, no matter how you make your decisions, even if it's the craziest decisions, the wrong decisions, and they don't feel like it's what's best for you, you know what's best for you. Do what you feel is best for you. And that's what I did. I did what I wanted to do. I did what I felt was best for me, and I succeeded with it. You know, I didn't just let the negativity hold me back, because if that would have happened, I wouldn't have that degree. So, you know, I did what my heart told me to do, and it told me to go to that school. Whatever happened, it doesn't, whatever came along with it, it don't matter. That's what really God led me to do and told me to do. You belong at this school. You belong at this school, and that's where I was. So, things was great at that school. I love that school. So, now it was time to move out. I moved out, and now I'm driving back to Jersey. And now it's just like, okay, it's about to be summer. What am I going to do? I need to apply to a school because I want my bachelor's degree. Like, duh. So I applied to three schools. Now, I applied to Rutgers. I applied to Montclair again, and I actually visited Montclair and Rutgers. And I applied to Ottawa University in Kansas. Now, the Kansas part came along because, you know, the guy that I was, you know, at the time, he ended up going to that school, you know, for football and stuff. And mind you, we were together. So, you know, I wanted, you know, like, that's, you know, the person who you messing with like that, and y'all really heavy, and y'all, it's been years, and y'all in it, you want to be with them, like, and that was me. I wanted to be with him, so obviously, like, I was just like, these other schools, you know, I'm just gonna, can't go, so, and also, too, y'all, like, y'all may probably think I'm stupid, or I'm dumb for, like, in a way, following a guy, but I didn't look at it like that, because at the end of the day, I still was getting it on my own. Like, this is what I wanted to do for me. It wasn't like, oh, you know, I'm doing it really for us in a way. You know, like, it was really for me, just like he's doing it for him, because you need that degree. So I ended up, you know, going out there, and they gave me also a partial scholarship in academics, because, you know, your girl made president's list, so they had to. So, yeah. So I ended up getting, you know, half of a scholarship, and, you know, that, you know, Rutgers and Montclair, I guess it was like, no, let me start with Montclair. Montclair, I guess, yeah, I visited the school and it was beautiful, but my love for it and feelings changed. I don't know. It just wasn't the same like I was in high school. And then Rutgers, I don't know. It was just like, it was, I don't know. And let me say this, it was my idea, but it also wasn't. So I wasn't very happy, but I was happy. But I was just like, this ain't it either. So Ottawa came along, and mind y'all, Kansas from New Jersey, that's a flight. You can drive 17 hours, almost 18 hours. Baby, that's a flight. That's a 3-hour flight. And, you know, when I touched down, y'all, the atmosphere, my scenery, everything was different. It was country. Everything was different. Everything was different for me because, you know, I'm from the East Coast. So everything was just different, the vibe. But it was also very calming, if I may say. Like, it was very calming. So things was just great, y'all. Things was great. You know, throughout that, my process to get into Ottawa, you know, I did apply, got accepted, of course. And I wanted, the main reason what drew me to the school was they had a dance team, and they have a cheer team. And I danced and cheered my life too, more so dance though. And I was just like, oh, I gotta be a part of this. This is my energy. I need to get back into it, back into dancing. Cause when I was dancing, I was in shape. So I was, and you know, not that that's an excuse that I, you know, you can be in shape in other ways, but dancing just was it. I don't know, it was just it. So when I found out they had a dance team, you know, I spoke to this lady there, Randy, and she was a big help. You know, she got me in to talk to the coach, and everything was just great from there. I ended up making a dance team, so I am on the dance team there. And the people there, the energy, the vibes, it's all great, you guys. Like, it's great, amazing. I met great people there, you know, and it's just, I love it. Like, I really love it. Now, I don't know if I would, like, live in Kansas, like, you know, after I graduate. But I will say that it is very different for me, but I like the different. You know, like, I feel like I don't want to live in New Jersey my entire life. You know, and Kansas, it's just different, y'all. I don't know the other word. It's just like a positive energy that makes you want to go back, if that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? It don't, like, I love being home right now, but I do miss it. You know what I'm saying? So, but, you know, things are just great. Like, my life there is great. You know, this is my last year. It's just beautiful. It's beautiful. You know, I am getting my master's as well. If you guys wanted to know, I am going to get my master's. So, yeah, it's just great energy for me, you guys. Great things have been coming my way. And all I can do is thank the man above, because, you know, I must be doing something right, you know? So, yeah, this is my college journey, my story. you know, it's been a long time, you know, getting to where I'm at, and it's been a process, but would I change it? No. Do I regret it? No. And if I could do it all over again, I would. I would. It's been nothing but really great, sad, happy, down, anger. It's been so many moments that I've had, even depressing times, but you know, it was beautiful and it still is beautiful. And I can't wait to take you guys on my journey of it ending, you know, and getting this degree, getting this bachelor's degree, you know. So I'm excited. And you know, leave me comments, you know, down below what you guys think, where you guys go to school, if you guys, you know, have similar journeys like my college journey, if you've been, you know, back and forth, transferred to different schools. Like, let me know. I really want to know, because this is something I don't talk about. Like, you know, I really don't. And I felt like, you know, this is something I need to share to let people know that you don't have to go to a four-year school. You don't have to start off at a four-year school. You could start off at a community college and still be successful and have something that you want to do. You know, you don't need a four-year school. You know, you can stop at your two-year, get that degree, and work on something. You know, you don't have to. And you also don't have to go to college, to be honest. But this is just what I wanted to do. And I'm so happy I did it. And I'm going to continue to stay on this journey. And I will keep you guys updated on it, of course, because it's not over yet. But I just thought I should share this with you guys. Because I do get questions from family members, from just people, like, how did you end up here? You know what I'm saying? And that's really the main question I always get, like, how did I end up there? And I'm just like, well, let me just make a story time on it so people could hear and really understand. You know what I'm saying? So that's my college journey story time. I love this story time. I'm so excited I got to share it with you guys. I have a bunch of more story times if you guys want to know. Let me know on Instagram. Let me know down below in the comments what you guys want to know more about. Yeah, like this video if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you're new. Hit that subscribe button. Hit it. Because you know you're enjoying these videos, especially with this bonnet on. Who you know that wear a bonnet and YouTube videos? Me. Because I'm not going to hide this from you guys. Like, this is the real me and my comfort. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. Leah Boo signing off. Bye.